Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to RNN News. I am Yasmin Sultana. Headlines of the news. UN criticizes Rohingya duel between Myanmar and Bangladesh. UN women open second multipurpose center for Rohingya women. November 2, 2018. Now into the details. Conditions in Rakhine State not yet conducive for return of refugees, said UNHCR. UN officials have condemned a disaster between Myanmar and Bangladesh to start repatriating Rohingya refugees, with the UN Refugee Agency confirming they have not been consulted about the plan. Bangladesh and Myanmar government officials announced this week they had struck a very concrete repatriation deal for the return of the 720,000 Rohingya refugees who fled a brutal military crackdown in August 2017, which would begin by mid-November. Myanmar officials said on Wednesday they had verified 5,000 Rohingya refugees so far, with the first batch of 2,000 to be repatriated in the next month. However, Stephane Dujarric, a spokesman for the UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, said the deal had taken the UN High Commissioner for Refugees, UNHCR, by surprise. To be clear, UNHCR, which is in a lead on the issues of refugees, was not consulted on this matter, said Dujarric at the daily press briefing given by the Secretary General's office. No one wants the tourist back, thanks of Rohingya arrest in Rakhine State. Shivris Major, the UNHCR senior external officer based in Cox's Bazar, Bangladesh, reiterated this, saying UNHCR was not a party to that agreement. We would advise against imposing any timetable or target figures for repatriation in respect of the voluntary nature and sustainability of return, added Major. It is unclear if refugees know their names are on this list that has been cleared by Myanmar. They need to be informed. They also need to be consulted if they are willing to return. It is critical that returns are not rushed or premature. Hundreds of thousands of Rohingya have been living in cramped refugee camps in Cox's Bazar for more than a year after fleeing rape, murder and arson in Rakhine State at the hands of the Myanmar military. The Myanmar government signed an agreement with the UNHCR in June that they would work with the UN to create safe and dignified conditions for the return of the Rohingya to Rakhine, including granting security, freedom of movement, and pathway to citizenship. None of these assurances have been met by the Myanmar government so far, and the UNHCR has only been given restricted access to Rakhine State. For UNHCR, the conditions in Rakhine State are not yet conducive for a return to Myanmar, said Dujarric. And at the same time, we are seeing Rohingya refugees continue to arrive from Rakhine State into Bangladesh, which should give you an indication of the situation on the ground. The center and activities are being run in partnership with Action Aid and YPSA, with technical assistance from the Women and Children Affairs Ministry. United Nations UN Women has launched its second multipurpose women's center, a one-stop hub for Rohingya women to access information on health and protection issues at a refugee camp in Cox's Bazar. The new center, built at Block A, Camp 4, is almost 3 times bigger than the one in Camp 18 and will provide a broader set of services, including cooking, mating, and training facilities in a safe and empowering environment for women, reports UNB. UN Women said on Thursday that it was running the center and activities in partnership with Action Aid and YPSA, with technical assistance from the Women and Children Affairs Ministry. Speaking at the luncheon event, Bangladesh Refugee Relief and Repatriation Commissioner V. Muhammad Abul Kalam said, "When women can prove that you are different from others, every step you are taking, I can see your dedication, support and a strong advocacy for Rohingya women. The center is also a one-stop hub for women to access information on gender-based violence and participate in leadership, life skills, and livelihood trainings. The centers offer women referral to health and gender-based violence support services. It will also be used as a shelter center in case of any disasters. UN Women empowers Rohingya women and girls through life skills training and supportive services. More than 15,000 women and girls have benefited from these services that have been provided through a similar multipurpose center in Camp 18 in Balukal since January 2018. I joined UN Women's training and now I can support my family. I feel that now I have more respect from my family. I am encouraging friends and family to come to the center," said Hasina Khatun, a Rohingya woman who has been coming to the first center speaking in front of the 118 guest present. At the luncheon ceremony, UN Women's Country Representative Shoko Ishika said, "I hope this plastic will eventually be managed by Rohingya women. It's their place and it should run according to their needs and run by them. I would like this center to be an integrator of services by various partners. We look forward to working with organizations with different expertise to bring up various skill building and information sessions for the Rohingya women. Thank you for listening. RNN News. Allah Hafiz."